Hello children, in the last video already we have studied about this lesson. So in the animal kingdom we have studied about types of the animals. There are two types of the animals. One is vertebrates and another one is invertebrates. Then depending upon their body structure and the presence of the backbone, we have divided into two types, vertebrates and the invertebrates. And even we have learned very clearly and got all the information about vertebrates and invertebrates, and even we have learned the types of vertebrates also. Then depending upon their habit of living and eating habit, we have another further information about the animals. So we know that the insects, birds and the human being and the other animals, these all will come under the animals only. Then we have differentiated only with the presence of backbone, that the vertebrates and the invertebrates. So including these all animals, again there we are going to study on the system of their food. We are going to divide into like this types or groups of animals. For example, the type of animals depending on their food, how the food they are going to eat. First one is carnivorous, second one is herbivorous, and third one is omnivorous. Of course, in your previous classes already you have learned what are carnivorous, herbivorous and the omnivorous. Depending on how the animals are eating, which type of food they are eating, we have made another three groups of animals, like carni, herbi and the omnivorous. Then what is this carnivorous? Carnivorous animals are those animals which eat animal meat of the animal. They will kill the animal, they will eat meat and flesh, fresh flesh of the animals. The animals which eat the other animals to survive themselves, those are called as carnivorous. For example, there are some animals, they are going to kill other animals and they will eat. The lion, tiger, leopard, so like these animals. These all will come under the carnivorous group. Then the herbivorous, the animals which eat plants and plant products. As we say that I am a pure vegetarian, I am not at all going to touch the non-veg also, like this we will be saying, then we all will come under herbivorous. If we are eating only plants and the plant products, we will come under this herbivorous, only plant products. We will come under this herbivorous group. Animals, it is a group of those animals which eat only plants and the plant products. Then omnivorous, omnivorous both. We have learned now both, that is plant plus animals. Plants plus animals. In this omnivorous group, there are the types of the animals. Some of the animals will be there. They eat both plants, leaves of the plants also they eat, grains, vegetable, fruits also they will eat. If they get the meat of the other animals or fresh flesh of the other animals, they are going to eat that also. For example, dog, cat and other animals. And even including human being and the birds. See, birds will eat fruit also, vegetables also, grains also, and even they will eat, even they will kill other insects and they will eat, otherwise they will eat meat of the other animals also. And even some animals will eat both. And even the human beings, we will eat plant and plant products. Along with that, even we will eat the animals also. We are going to kill the animals and we are going to eat the meat of the animal. So like this, animals will come in the last group, that is plant omnivorous group. Now you got clearly that how many types we have divided depending on their food, animal, how they are going to take the food. We have divided into three types: carnivorous, herbivorous and the omnivorous. Okay. So in the living things, we know that the animals, other animals and even the human body or human being, both will come in a living things. Even the plants also going to come in, living things. But can you think that is there any similarities between the animals and the human being? Okay, let us see the similarities now. See, there are some of the similarities even for the other animals and even for the human beings also. For example, as the human being is going to respire, respire means what? Breathing. That is breath or breathing. Breathing is similar for both human being as well as other animals also, isn't it? Even all the animals are going to breathe, respire. Then both will eat food. Human beings, we need food. If there is no food, there is no energy for our body, we can't get any energy in our body, then we have to eat the food. Other animals, that animal may be anyone, that may be bird, that may be small insect, that may be a fish, that may be a small earthworm, or that may be a big elephant. Each and every animals need food for their survival. Then third one, similarities of animals and human beings. Third one is growth. Other animals also have the growth. Human being is also having the growth. Gradually, as the time increases, we have the growth for our body. When other animals born, babies of other animals born, or babies of human being born, they will be of the very small size. Then gradually, how the time increases, even their growth also increases. Then both can move. Animals also can move, human being also can move. A human being, we can move from one place to another place. We have the legs. But even other animals also, they have the legs. They can also move from one place to another place. And then, both can reproduce. What is this reproduction? In the already in the third study, we have discussed that. What is reproduction means? The animals which are going to give birth to the young ones. Okay. Either they are going to give birth to the direct babies, or they can lay the eggs. Human beings also going to give the birth to the babies. Even other animals are also going to give birth to the babies. And some of the animals are there. They are going to lay the eggs. Inside the eggs, there will be a baby. Isn't it? So, almost each and every animals, including a human being, we both are going to reproduce the another young one, babies. Then response to the change. How the human being have the sense organs, see, in the same way even the other animals, birds, insects, even they are also having the sense organs. If there is sudden change takes place in the surrounding of those particular area, particular animal, they are going to respond to the change. This happens, this is a similarities, next similarities between animals and the human beings. And we both have, that is the animals and the human being have life cycle. Life cycle. You know that already in the third standing you have learned what is life cycle. Life cycle means born, first will be small baby or young baby, then adult, then age, medium age, then aged, and again the death, again the small baby, and again the adult, and the young, and the aged, and the death. So like this, each and every animals we have like this life cycle, isn't it? When we born, how we were very small, again gradually our age also increased, and even size also increased, and even our energy level is also increased. And once we have got so much of age, again we are going to lose the energy. At once, after some years, we are going to die, isn't it? This is called as the life cycle. See here, how many similarities we have learned for the animals and the human beings: breathing, food, growth, movement, reproduce or reproduction, response to the change, and the life cycle. So these all are the most, so only we call as animals, plants and even the human being as living things, because they all are going to perform these all features. Okay, so how we have similarities, there must be a differences also for human being and the other animals. What are those differences? For example, human being have two legs and two hands. Two legs and two hands. Whereas animals have only legs, they don't have the hands. And then human being can talk and express their feelings. Of course, the animals also may be having feelings, but they are unable to express. Why? Because they cannot talk. Then human being will wear the cloth. Okay, but naturally the animals will not wear any cloth, but naturally in the skin they have capacity to adjust their bodies to the surrounding. We are wearing cloths. Then any guess? Okay, two legs, two hands, two legs and two hands. We are going to talk, we are going to wear the cloths, but whereas animals will not wear the cloths, they cannot take. And how we are going to eat? We are going to eat by the help of the hands, but the animals are going to take their whole head to the presence of the foot, isn't it? So these all are the some differences where we can see in between the animals and the human body. So today we have learned the three types of animals depending upon their food system, which type of food they are going to eat, and then we have learned the similarities between the animals and the human being and the differences between the animals and the human being. So before winding up this today's class, I would like to give you homework. Write down 10 similarities of human being and the animals. There is a similarities between human being and the animals, you have to write. I have given very few. You have to write minimum 10. Okay, understood? I hope you all will do the homework. So let's meet in the next video. Bye-bye.